The focus of this video is atomic structure. Specifically, it covers most of Chapter 2 in your textbook, which is labeled Atoms, Molecules, and Ions. Here you will see the topics that we are going to be discussing. We're going to run through some atomic history, review the parts of the atom, discuss elements and symbols, how to calculate various parts of atomic structure, discuss isotopes, and how to find atomic mass. Here you will see that there's a graphic organizer or table that has some pretty important people on it that helped in the development of the atom. The first time that the word atom was introduced was back in about 400 BC when Democritus, probably going to mess up most of these names, sorry about that in advance, said that everything that was on Earth that we could see was made up of teeny tiny little particles, and he called them atomos. So you can see in the diagram there that a stone is made up of a whole bunch of different tiny pieces of stone, and that your animal has a whole bunch of different tiny pieces of fur. Right? So basically he said that atoms were the smallest piece possible for any material. Around the same time that he was suggesting this idea of atomos, Aristotle, who was a very famous philosopher, said, no, this is wrong. Everything on Earth is made of four elements, and those four elements are earth, air, fire, and water. Being that Aristotle was much more well known than Democritus, this is what was believed for a very long time. In the end, it turned out he was wrong. Many years go by, a lot of science takes place, a lot of experimentation, and finally, in the late 1700s, a guy by the name of John Dalton, who was a school teacher, came up with the atomic theory of matter. Within his atomic theory of matter, he had four postulates that kind of summarized some of the important things at that time that had been discovered about atoms. They basically said things like, matter is made of atoms. Also noted that they cannot be, you know, matter cannot be created or destroyed. And finally, it also said that all oxygen atoms were the same. So for the same element, your atoms were identical. There were a few others as well. Again, scientists are going through experimentation, they're trying things, they're making hypotheses, and the end of the 1800s, right around 1896, J.J. Thomson discovered the electron. He used a cathode ray. This is a picture of that. And when he discovered the electron, he said, oh, if there are negative charges, there must also be positive charges within the atom. So from that, he said, this is what an atom looks like, as you can see here. And it was noted to be the plum pudding model, because it looks like plum pudding. He basically stated that the positive and the negative charges were found throughout the atom. Some years go by, and Ernest Rutherford was another scientist, and he kind of wanted to test Thomson's theory. So around 1910 was when he came up with his experiment and his discovery. He's known for his gold foil experiment, which you can see here. He took some particles, they were alpha particles, which are positively charged, and he sent them through a very, very, very thin piece of gold foil. If Thomson's model was correct, what should have happened is all the particles should have pretty much gone through and not deflected. And as you can see here in this diagram, most of them did, but some of them deflected. Since some of them deflected, he said, "Wait a minute, Thompson's model must not be correct." Instead, he said that the atom must have a positive core, and it was coined the nucleus. Over the years, a lot of other models have been produced and a lot of other experiments have taken place, which eventually led to the modern model of the atom, which is on the next slide. The modern model of the atom is mostly empty space. You can see it there in the diagram. There are two major regions. We have the nucleus, which hopefully you already know contains your protons and your neutrons. And we have the electron cloud, which is where the electrons are found. Okay. Down below is a chart on subatomic particles. Again, for the most part, should be review from some science class that you previously have taken. Protons are usually represented with a P, neutrons are an N, and electrons are an E with a negative. Protons have a positive charge. Neutrons are neutral, and electrons are negative 1. The protons and neutrons are both in the nucleus, as noted above, and the electrons are found in your electron cloud. Relative mass to one another, we say that protons and neutrons both have a mass of 1, and that electrons have a mass of 0, because they're actually about 2,000 times smaller than your protons and your neutrons. So these two particles are going to make up the mass of your atom. Let's talk about chemical symbols. You will need a periodic table. Complete chemical symbols contain a mass number, an atomic number, and the actual chemical symbol on the periodic table. They also can have a charge if they're not atoms and instead they are ions. So this right here is your complete chemical symbol. You can see that right here is the mass number. Down here is what we call the atomic number. This would be the charge if there is one. And of course, this is the element symbol. We're going to be using these numbers to assist us in calculating the number of protons, neutrons, and electrons that something has. What is an atom? An atom is something that has a neutral charge because your protons equal your electrons. It is actually also known as the smallest particle that still represents an element. Okay, so let's get back to our study. The smallest particle that represents an element. The atomic number, which is on your periodic table, it's always the smaller number of the two in each chemical symbol box, is equal to the number of protons. This gives the element its identity. You change the protons, you would change the element. And finally, we have the mass number, which is actually on the table, the rounded atomic mass usually, and this is the protons plus the neutrons. Therefore, if you were asked to calculate neutrons, you would take the mass number minus the atomic number. Let's move on and discuss a few more things. We're going to review and kind of compare and contrast atoms, ions, and isotopes. As you can see, I have completed this chart. Atoms have protons that equal the electrons, so they're neutral. Ions are charged because the protons do not equal the electrons. When you have more protons, it's going to be positive. When you have more electrons, it's going to be negative for the charge. To calculate electrons, you take the protons minus the provided charge. We will practice that. And then finally, we have something called an isotope, which has the same protons, but a different number of neutrons. That means that an isotope has a different mass number. And you'll see the examples there as well. Under isotopes, you'll see that it says C-12, C-13, and C-14. Those are the mass numbers for those particular atoms. Let's do a little bit of practice. So you're going to be asked to determine the protons, neutrons, electrons, identify the atomic number, mass number, charge, as well as the complete symbol if it's not given. Here, what we'll do is we'll just kind of go through the protons, neutrons, and electrons. So for this first example, this is the mass number. So I would look up uranium on the periodic table. I would see that uranium is number 92. So that means I have 92 protons. You'll notice that there's no given charge for uranium. Therefore, it also has 92 electrons. And to calculate its neutrons, I'm going to take the mass number, 235, minus the atomic number, which is 92, and I'm going to get 143. Okay. Let's drop down and do this one. So you find copper on your periodic table. It's element number 29. So it has 29 protons. Using your periodic table, you can determine that it has 35 neutrons through subtraction. And to determine the number of electrons, we're going to say electrons equals our protons, which is 29, minus our given charge of 2, and we get 27. At this time, please pause the video and try the remaining examples. Please check your answers. Again, to calculate neutrons, you're taking the mass number minus the atomic. And to find electrons, you're taking the protons minus the charge. If no charge is provided, it is an atom, and therefore the protons and electrons are the same. Another way that you could be asked to calculate atomic structure or illustrate your knowledge of atomic structure is this. So you could be given a chart, asked to identify the atomic number and the mass number, determine the number of protons, remember this is equal to the atomic number, calculate your number of neutrons, remember this is mass number minus atomic number, the mass number is rounded, as well as calculate the number of electrons, which we said before was protons minus the charge, and then atoms versus ions. Please pause the video and try these practice problems. Please check your answers. You'll notice that for the aluminum, I have less electrons than protons because I'm positively charged. And for the oxygen, I have more electrons than protons because I'm negatively charged. Because, of course, when you subtract a negative, you get a positive. The last part of atomic structure is calculating atomic mass. Atomic mass is defined as the weighted average of the masses of all isotopes for an element. Its unit is the AMU. To solve the problems, you can see the steps there. We convert to decimals, multiply them by the masses, and then we find the sum. So we'll do the example problem. I'm going to move my decimal 2 spaces for each of these. So I have 0.7577 times the mass of 35. And I have 0.2423 times the mass of 37. I'm going to solve both of those, add them together, and get 35.4846 AMU. Do not round for these. Okay? So percent to a decimal, multiply, and then add them together. Please pause the video and try the last practice problem. You can see the work for this practice problem. I moved my decimal over 2 spaces for all of them, multiplied them by their given mass, and then I added the 3 values together to get 20.1877. This concludes our study of atomic structure.